Whoever is not well-mannered in his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will patch him up, will deal with him under the earth. Say wallahi, you're not going to tell anybody. We hear this all the time. Say wallahi, you're not going to tell anybody. Is there anything wrong with asking one to swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to conceal a very sensitive secret? The answer is no. But my brothers and my sisters, every best friend has a close friend, as they say. You've told this individual now. It could be so that he's not somebody who's reliable. He has a best friend and he goes and tells him as well. And he says to him, say wallahi, you're not going to tell anybody. And then he goes to his bed, and so on and so forth. Chinese whispers, the name of Allah Azza wa Jal is used in vain. This is a very bad characteristic to have, very bad trait. And Al-Islam has come to protect the secrets. He has spoken quite extensively with regards to being trusted and being trustworthy. We've even been told that one of the four characteristics of nifaq, hypocrisy, is وَإِذَا تُمِنَ خَانَ إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَّبَ وَإِذَا وَعَدَ أَخْلَفَ وَإِذَا تُمِنَ خَانَ. When he is trusted, he breaks the trust. It's a sad reality that this is now even becoming widespread amongst those who go out to study. He just can't hold himself together. He tells his closed ones before it actually becomes public information. And trust, my brothers and my sisters, is like a vase. What happens when the vase smashes into the ground? Can you put the pieces back up together again? The answer is no, you can't. And that's exactly how broken trust is. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِذَا حَدَّثَ الرَّجُلُ الْحَدِيثَ ثُمَّ الْتَفَتَ فَهِيَ أَمَانَةٌ. If one says something, he tells you, gives you a piece of information, and then he begins to turn to his sides, whether it's his left or whether it's his right, this is a clear indication that this is what? A secret. He doesn't want you to go out and spread this to others. Then this is a trust. The shurah, those who explain the hadith, they say he doesn't have to turn to his left and turn to his right. The fact that he's given you some indication is enough. I conclude with this advice of the mother of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, أتاني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنا ألعب مع الغلمان. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came to me while I was playing with the kids. فبعثني في حاجة فأبطأت على أمي. He sent me to go and do something, and I ended up coming home late to my mother. فلما أتيت إلى أمي, when I came to my mother, she asked him, ما حبسك? What caused you to come late? Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu responded back and he said, بعثني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حاجة. Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم sent me to go and do something. So she asked, وما حاجته? What did he tell you to do? He responded back and he said, إنها سر. It is a secret. What was her response? Did she say, wallahi, I'm not going to tell anybody. This is going to stay private. Look at this righteous mother, this sincere advisor. Look what she said. An amazing advice that every single one of us need to take into consideration. She said to him, فَلَا تُحَدِّثَنَّ بِسِرِّ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَحَدًا. Do not tell anybody about the secrets of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. أَحَدًا here is an indefinite that has now come in a negative context. And we learn this in قواعد الفقهية. وَالنَّكِرَاتُ فِي سِيَاقِ النَّفِي تُعْطِي الْعُمُومَ أَوْ سِيَاقِ النَّهِي. It means absolutely nobody. It is generalized. If an indefinite comes in a negative context, it indicates it being in general. Indicates generality. Not your mother, not your father, not the jinn, huh? Not your close ones, nobody. That's what it means. So ittaqillah, when it comes to the secrets of others, it is a serious sin. And it is feared for that person if he constantly does this, that he really becomes close to those who are hypocrites. And Allah knows best. The worst of those in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jal on the Day of Judgment is a man who did things with his wife. Pay attention here, with his wife. After all of this takes place, what does he do? He takes this and he spreads it to the people. I did this with my wife and I did that. She said this and she said that.